In this video, I want to show you how to set up an Odbc driver using Windows 8.1. An Odbc driver is a connection that you have to have if you want to use maybe a SQL Server database or an Oracle database or other kind of Odbc databases with maybe Excel or Access or with Crystal Reports. The Odbc driver is kind of a bridge between those programs and the larger database, and it's a necessary component. So let's see how we're going to set that up in Windows 8.1. I'm going to pick on Start, and you're looking for the control panel. So I'm going to pick on this down arrow, and in this case, if I pick on PC Settings, this is one way to get to the control panel. I'll pick on PC Settings, and notice over here it does say Control Panel. In the control panel, we're looking for something that's called System and Security. And then here, you're going to look for Administrative Tools. Under Administrative Tools, one of them is going to be called Odbc Data Sources. So you can either use 32-bit or 64-bit. I believe my SQL Server was 64-bit, so, and my Windows operating system was 64-bit, so I'm going to try this one. And we'll double-click on that. Now, you're going to see that your computer comes with some ODBC drivers already installed, like for DBase files, Excel, and for Access. Now, a lot of people ask me, what's the difference between user DSN and system DSN? User DSN will just be for that individual user who's using the computer at that moment, for the person who's logged on. The system DSN will be for everybody who uses that computer. So that's the difference. We're going to go with user DSN, and I'll pick on Add. And now it does recognize that the SQL Server is out there. So I'm going to pick on SQL Server, and I'll pick on Finish. Now it's asking for the name of the connection. So I'm going to call this one SQL Server. And the description will be SQL Server. Now, hopefully, when you pick on the pull-down for the server, this should come up. And so in this case, we need the name of the SQL Server. So if it didn't find it like that, I know why it didn't find it. There's a service that didn't start up. So in this case, what I'll do is actually start the SQL Server using the Studio so I can get the name of it. So I'm going to go back to the Start menu and pick on the SQL Server Management Studio. And this way I'll actually get the name of the server. Here it is right there. So I'm actually going to copy that. And I'll go back to my other screen now. Now I should be able to paste that right in, and then it should find it. Okay. In this case, we're going to do with SQL Server Authentication. This way, it allows us to put our username and password. I'll type in the username and password. Now, in this case, you can usually, you want to change your default database. You don't want to go to the master database. You want to pick a database that you would have made. The master database is like the system database for SQL Server. You don't want to really use that one at all, so I'll pick on the database that I made. And we're good there. We'll pick on Next. In this case, usually on this screen, we don't have to change anything. We're good there. And I'll pick on Finish. Now we're going to test the data source connection. And in fact, it tested completed successfully. So that's how you set up an ODBC driver in Windows 8.1. And now I'm sure that if I go into Access or Excel or Crystal Reports, it should recognize the SQL Server driver. Let me just see if that's the case. So I'll go into Access 2013. And in this case, I'm on a form, so I'm gonna close that window. And in this case, you pick on the External Data tab of Access, and there is one that's called ODBC Database. And you can see that I'm gonna go ahead, well, we'll do an import and we'll click on OK. And you can see that Access, in fact, is seeing the SQL Server ODBC driver, and that's telling me that it's in there correctly. So I'm gonna pick on cancel there. So that's how we set up an ODBC driver in Windows 8.1. I'm sure that would work in Windows 8 and in Windows 7, pretty much the exact same steps. I'll pick on stop.